Last week, our 14 would-be supermodels faced their first assignments.
We need to get this heart rate going. We need more skipping. We need more push-ups. Come on.
The judges decided which three didn't make the grade.
Isaac, Sarah, Thackeray.
But the final decision was yours.
One of you cannot be made into a supermodel.
In just moments, you'll learn who stays for another chance to become a supermodel and who goes home. Also tonight, has bad boy Billy struck again?
You just made an idiot of yourself. Oh, I'm sorry, mate, but you did.
Sparks fly as one of the girls catches Luke's eye.
You are almost the sexiest girl in the world.
The knives are already out.
Just not versatile enough, like.
Yeah, I knew girls were bitchy, but seriously, I didn't know it was that bad.
And
poor little Isaac, I mean, he probably doesn't have the best body shape for swimming.
The models go for gold in their workout.
I feel like I'm about to die and collapse.
So if I had to choose out of Sarah and Thackeray to go, I'd have to choose probably Thackeray.
Definitely one of us going home today, so what's it going to be?
Sort of really numb. I don't really feel anything for some reason. I really think that I'm probably going home.
Isaac, Sarah, Thackeray, one of you will be going home today. Last week we stripped you down to expose the real you, but you didn't perform as well as your fellow models. Australia has now decided one of you cannot be made into a supermodel.
Isaac, last week your catwalk and your photo shoot was stiffer than the concrete you pour. For you to continue in this, you'll have to step it up.
Sarah, at the photo shoot, you just weren't in tune with your body, and your fitness and training have let you down.
Thackeray, you ignored our advice and continued to weight train, and your walk on the catwalk was heavy and flat-footed. You've shown no improvement. You've got to step it up.
Okay, Australia has voted. Here is the decision. Isaac. Australia has given you another chance to be a supermodel. Well done.
Thank you.
Thackeray, Sarah. Today, one of you will be going home. Sarah, Australia has voted, and you are safe. Thackeray, I'm sorry we cannot make you into a supermodel. You may all now leave the catwalk.
I was surprised. I was very surprised with it, but hey. Australia said that I can't be a supermodel, so I can't be.
Anyone actually got an idea or a feeling perhaps inside?
Sarah's made a lot of progress in the last few days and I'm really proud.
She's lost 3 kilos.
I think everyone sort of had their own opinion who they wanted to come through, but I want to see Isaac. You know, I'm not going to deny that. I wanted to see his mug walk through this room.
If there's one person that I wanted to come back into that door, it was definitely this Sarah. so happy. I think I was the first one that jumped up when she walked through the door.
Come on, Sarah, what did we tell you?
After we realised Sarah was still in and she walked in through the doors, we realised that all the girls were still here, so that was awesome.
I'm so relieved. It was the most horrible thing that could ever happen. I'm just standing there and, like, she said it and she's just like, Sarah.
Who said it?
Jen. Oh. Jen said it. She's like, Sarah, you have a second chance.
So a girl was in, that's the worst part, because now the boys are one down. And then it was between Isaac and Bakary, and I'm not gonna lie, I wanted Isaac to stay for sure. Like, Isaac's one of my best friends. Door open, Isaac walks through, and next thing I knew, we had him buried in the couch and there was about 10 people on top of him, so.
The action I got was pretty intense. It was massive. Everybody was pretty happy to have me back.
All right, guys, come on, let's go. Come on.
Hey.
All right.
Hello, models. Welcome to Renew Exciter's City Salon. You guys look really nervous, actually. Are you nervous?
Yeah, a little bit.
Yeah? Now, today is all about change. So we're going to transform you into supermodels.
I could not believe that we were going to get our haircuts and my hair was in the condition it was.
As Chadwicks will represent you, you will also represent Chadwicks. So it's important that you look your absolute best. And that's going to mean some pretty major changes for some of you. And that's part of the business, so get ready.
Models, this is Renia Exitis. This is her salon. It's wonderful. Include Kate Blanchett, Toni Collette, and Naomi Watts. So some Aussies there.
Okay, let's go. How do you feel about going shorter?
How much shorter? I'm just asking.
I reckon a bit. Your hair is so important, especially in our industry. It's going to get tortured, it's going to get played with, so it's important that they really know how to look after it and to realise what they can do with it to change their looks.
Mr. Reese.
Yeah, I think we can go short.
Shape.
I really think you're going to carry it.
You sure?
I do.
Take it off.
This change is do or die for me. I mean, I was in top three last week, which surprised me, which is great, and I'm thinking, well, this is either going to keep me there or it's going to just send me home next week.
What comes down to this? How bad do I want it?
All right, let's keep your head down.
So what's the length? Maybe there?
Yeah, that's it there.
Yeah? Okay.
That's it there.
Okay. It's really scary for me because it's out of my hands and I've had short hair before and it looked horrible. It doesn't suit me.
Let's do it.
Yeah. Oh my God.
You want to hold on to that?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah, you can cry later. With Brooke's hair, we had discussed it a lot. We looked for more of an androgynous sort of stylish look, softened her look a little bit more.
I'm excited. I really like it. It's pretty much what I wanted to get.
It'll just look really cool, really modern.
You've got to trust us. You're going to have to make a change. It's going to be really important for you. It's going to bring out your features, okay? You're going to love it, you know? I know it's a bit traumatic. I know. You're very attached to your hair, but I'm...
This is a great opportunity. I don't suit short hair. My face is
going to... It's not going to be too short. It's just going to be nice, okay? It's going to bring out your features. Trust Brenda. She really knows what she's doing, all right?
Oh, I trust you.
Okay.
I shouldn't be crying, but it's just... I think it's just a shock. I'm in shock. But, you know, my mum always said, Sarah, go short. So, here you go, mum.
Martin and Jennifer chose this type of hairstyle for me for a reason. It wasn't much of a change, but I do think it will benefit me in my modelling career.
See how surprised?
surprised that they didn't change Shanina's look.
I know. I was actually really surprised too, because I didn't think it looked versatile at all. To be in this industry, you need to be able to carry a few different looks, and I haven't seen Shanina carry a different look yet.
Mum said one thing to me when I was doing the show. She goes, whatever you do, don't let them shave your head. You look silly. What am I doing? Give myself a comb over now.
Okay, guys, I've got a surprise for you. You ready?
Yeah.
Oh! Beautiful. Look at that.
Coming up, the models learn it's not all glamour in the fashion world.
It's going to get a little slimy.
And
we are all out of our comfort zone, whereas I think that you're still within your comfort zone.
Once again, the girls are just going to be put back in their place and probably going to have to come out with bigger knives.
Hey, models. Today is all about selling unglamorous glamour.
We're here at this food processing plant, and yeah, it's going to get a little slimy and a little smelly, so enjoy yourself, models.
Yeah. Oh, I can smell it.
Today you'll be working with world-renowned photographer Jonathan Bukalil. He's worked with celebrities and models including Heidi Klum, Elizabeth Hurley, and Misha Barton. Thank you, welcome.
It's going to be cold, it's going to be wet, and it will smell. So I'm going to challenge you today, so it's up to you guys to bring it.
Okay, Miles, go get styled.
It has really become guys versus girls, so I mean, this week we've got to knock out a girl. That's all there is to it.
I'm fearless. I'm excited.
I think the guys are bringing it this week. Their whole attitude has changed. You can feel it. You know, they got new haircuts now.
Yeah.
The girls are in for a run for their money this time around.
I'm feeling really, really, really good at the moment. I'm excited to work with Fish.
Girls are all mad. Like, they're mad fun, and they keep the energy really pumped in the house. But, you know, one minute they're fighting, one minute they're in love, and then one minute, you know, someone said something bad.
You get Hannah always bitching about Shanina coming up with all these wild ideas of why she's not had as much haircut.
What I've been saying the last few days is that your versatility is very limited now because of your exoticness.
Mm. And the girls will start talking about haircuts, and I believe that it sort of got a little bit unfriendly.
Just not versatile enough, like, as if that they couldn't do something really extreme because you'd only suit one look, which is what you have.
I think that they should have done a more extreme look with Shanina, because she's just going to look the same in every single photo.
Her lack of versatility and lack of life experience just doesn't compare to me, really. So I just want you to know that we are all out of our comfort zone, whereas I think that you're still within your comfort zone, so you've got room
whereas
to smack us all
down. Whereas if they shaved your hair off, you wouldn't be so much in your comfort zone. You'd have to look in the mirror and do your different angles like what Hannah and I did.
If that's what they want, that's what they want. I can't have really much say in it, you know what I mean?
Cassie and Hannah realise that Shanina is a really, really amazingly beautiful girl, and she is a threat in this competition.
Like, I'm not doing any of this to put you down. Like, I don't want you to think that
at all.
Don't
worry, no.
Just wanted to show the judges I could do well. I'm not really worried about what other people think to me, because I don't think it's going to help me.
She has nothing to worry about, and once again, the girls are just going to be put back in their place and probably going to have to come out with bigger knives.
Wow, shit. Yes. That does look great.
Well, Shanina came into the shoot with a bit of outside pressure on her. It seems all the other girls are saying that she's not very versatile.
I think I've proven my versatility by, like, putting a fish in my mouth. Not many people would do that.
Excellent. Very sexy.
I think when she took that bite, she was probably thinking it was Hannah's neck.
That's it. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful.
Competition phase has kicked in, and I'm really excited. This is going to get good and gory.
That's it. There, right there. Fabulous.
Hannah was one of the ones where it was actually quite natural. The clothes
looked right on her. She had the right body. And I think she just slipped into the role very quickly. Excellent. I think we've got that. I was very inspired, thank you.
Hannah's pissing me off. Oh my god. I knew girls were bitchy, but seriously, I didn't know it was that bad. She thinks she's God's gift to freaking everyone. And it's all gonna come crashing down soon, I think.
Bored but strong, okay?
I'm playing this game so much smarter than anyone else.
That's great. Like, that's great.
I haven't seen anyone else try and get an understanding of what Jonathan wants from us today.
Okay.
Should I be leaning forward, maybe?
That's it.
That's
yeah.
Great.
Excellent.
I think that I've got that edge on everyone else.
Yeah. I like that. Yeah. I like it when
Excellent.
You're pulling it close.
Excellent. The competition is definitely hotting up at the moment because each one is so willing to take the hit and to actually get very dirty with things. There you go. Great. Yeah, that's it.
Sorry.
All right, okay.
Really,
really
stinky.
Yeah, darker though. That's darker. It. I don't want you to have that smoke thing.
I reckon I've done okay. I sure as hell do not want to be in the bottom four again.
I don't think he's just really the look I go for in a guy. I just think he's maybe a little bit too commercial. Not really menacing with it. That's it. Yeah, go on.
I really enjoyed that. And I think I did all right. I think I did a lot better than my last shoot.
His body is a little bit stiff. He needs to learn to relax a little bit more. If I were to choose a bottom three, he could very well be amongst them. Hang on.
Yeah, that's what I thought. I was like, come on.
Clipped?
Have they clipped you there?
Yeah, they have. Because her dress is huge.
Courtney's dress was a little bit big, so it did affect her in some of the shots, yeah.
You used that as something to work with.
I had to try and work, pulling the dress up into my shoot, which I tried really hard, but I don't think he was very impressed. Doing my best, Jonathan.
But we can do better.
With this competition, you know, you have to get better and better, so the girls got to stay on their A game.
There you go.
Very good, very good.
Good. You got it now.
Stick your butt out a little bit more. Arch your back. Brooke was the least natural of all the girls. If I didn't tell her exactly what to do, we wouldn't have a photograph. But all right, now I need more from their face. Even bite the corner of it, okay? They all need to take it a little further and be less aware of everyone around.
That's, you know, they're young, they're green still, so they still got a long way to go before they're supermodels.
Yeah.
Photo shoot was great, but the fitness training, really, really hard.
Welcome, guys. We've got a bit of a surprise for you today.
When James said that he had a surprise for us, I had no idea.
So I was thinking it would be a celebrity.
As you know, swimmers have got the best lean-looking body. So today's session is in the pool. Your swimming coach, she's won 3 gold Olympic medals at Beijing Olympics. Let me introduce you to Stephanie Rice. Hey, going good. Yeah, good. Congratulations.
Yeah, thank you. So basically this morning I just wanted to come in and have a look at you guys' stroke and, you know, the importance of training is not only for your health and all that sort of thing, but for you guys especially just to keep toned and keep in shape.
At the moment there's no bigger name than Stephanie Rice, so it's awesome to have her here. I can't wait. It's probably the best thing that's happened so far in the comp for me.
Ready? I didn't know that swimming would be like a really good way of turning and shaping, but today I'm really looking forward to it. I mean, I just want to do anything to get myself in shape.
Go, Sharon, go, go, go!
Okay, so are you doing freestyle or breaststroke?
Breaststroke.
Okay, breaststroke. We need to, are you put your face in the water?
Sorry?
Face in the water? Poor little Isaac, I mean, he probably doesn't have the best body shape for swimming. Guys that are really built don't float well in the water. Come on, Isaac. Oh, it's fun and kind of funny trying to comment on people that don't have very good technique because you got to go right back to the basics.
I feel like I'm about to die and collapse. I had to stop halfway because I felt like I was going to vomit.
I guess because, you know, I'm so used to swimming 6 or 7K a session, so, you know, they just did about 80 metres and they're puffing away. The more puffing that they can get going, the better they'll get.
Up next.
We want to strip away the old you and embrace the new you.
But how far are the muddles prepared to go?
This is bloody serious, and I really, really want this.
The whole group of us arrived at the Marie Claire party in style. We arrived there in a Hummer, and there were so many people there, it was hard to move. We started to see like people that we recognised from magazines and on television, and it started to set in that we're actually at an amazing party with amazing people there.
Hello, models. Now, tonight there's some very important people here and very influential people in the industry. So it's all about having fun, but be on your best behaviour.
Tonight is your chance to meet the who's who of the fashion industry. Tonight is not a party for you. Tonight is work. You are working models trying to impress the industry.
A go-see is extremely important because most people want to see the model in the flesh before they'll book them.
So Sheridan and Courtney, this is Carlos and Harry.
Nice to meet you, Carlos. I'm Sheridan.
Hi guys, hi. I want to introduce you to Simon Zimmerman.
Hello.
And Akira Izagawa.
Hello.
Cassie, Hannah, this is the wonderful Alice McCall.
Hey Alice, nice to meet you.
I actually think it's nice when a model looks like they've dressed themselves or they can dress themselves, not just a clothes horse. Hannah's definitely got that.
At the end of the night, things went really, really weird.
Flower?
Yeah.
Okay. Hold on, let me fix my bling, girl.
All right,
you all right? Yeah, there you go.
Look, to be honest, if anyone asks me my opinion of Tyson, I reckon Tyson's a mad dude.
Yeah, the night is early. What trouble can we get in later?
I had briefed Billy. I had spoken to Billy before, told him there were some very important people in the room, and I told him to behave. I told him not to drink. First thing I see, he's got a glass in his hand.
You only live once, you know what I mean? What are you going to do? If you're not someone extraordinary, you're just the ordinary.
It didn't impress me. You know, it's fine for Tyson. Tyson already is a supermodel, but Billy's got a long way to go before he is one. I love you to death, Billy, but, mate, you just shot yourself in the foot. There is major fashion designs in this house, and you just made an idiot of yourself. Oh, I'm sorry, mate, but you did. I'm really sorry, but you did.
I understand that, man. That's cool. I love you.
Cassie and Lou, I think they're very close. Actually, I know that they're very close.
You are almost the sexiest girl in the world, but Cassie's hotter.
Yeah,
you suck at this.
Also, I think that Billy and Courtney, they've got a really sort of tight bond. I'm not too sure. I think it's friendship borderline, something more.
I just wanted a bit of peace and quiet once I got home. I just wanted to be able to chill out. Then Lucas started complaining about the fact that he was in the bottom four because of he was chewing gum.
I get put in the bottom four because I had chewing gum in my mouth, and here's Tyson jumping in at a party buck naked.
I think that he just needs to be able to identify within himself that there is progress that he needs to make and stop whinging about it. There were people who were more deserving of being safe. Like, you weren't in the bottom three. Okay, be grateful that you're still here. Don't be bringing up shit from the past, okay? It's over and done. It's a new week.
I will talk about whatever I want, when I want, and I'm sick of you butting in and making comments about what I think and feel. And if I say that I felt that was unprofessional... No, don't whatever. That's how
I
feel.
It's 9:30 at night. I haven't been home since 7 o'clock this morning. I just want to chill out for 5 seconds and everyone's complaining.
I didn't say that I was Hannah.
Everyone's had a big night. Let's just go to bed. You guys obviously aren't getting along. No need to talk to each other.
No, I do get along with Hannah. We're just having a disagreement.
No, you guys do get along. Right now, you're just tired. Everyone just needs a bit of sleep, that's all.
Wake up, boys, wake up, what's going on? Hey, dressed to impress, all right? Come on, get dressed. Come on, get dressed. You got somebody to meet, somebody to impress this morning, all right? So put on your best, okay? Hey, ladies, good morning! Good morning, ladies, let's go! Dressed to impress, you got 20 minutes, guys. Let's go. Come on, babies, let's go.
You can still hear him going. I'm not that fond of Americans anymore.
I think it looks like crap at the moment. From the night before, we had a really late night.
I had a bit of a confrontation with Hannah last night, just about, you know, being overbearing and stuff. Today I'll be a lot of time, I'm sorry, you know, kind of thing, but secretly, I don't regret it.
We arrived at location. We walked through the big doors and this was this amazing warehouse with graffiti all over it.
I was thinking maybe some sort of thuggish photo shoot when I walked in here, you know, with all the graffiti in the background and the old trams busted in, but I was wrong, that's for sure.
Thanks for getting dressed to impress, guys, because the person you're going to impress is me. It's time to embrace your supermodel lifestyles, okay? We want to strip away the old you and embrace the new you. So what I'm going to ask you to do is put an article of clothing in the fire. The more you throw in, the more you're going to get out of this business and the more impressed I'm going to be with you, okay?
I was thinking the whole time, how much do I want this? And that this is bloody serious, and I really, really want this.
Come on, Billy. I know you was gonna do it. This man right here, earlier in the week, I was mad at him. Now, he's impressed me every time I see this boy.
I knew Billy would be the first up. It was just inevitable. It's like he does anything for a bit of attention.
Come on, step up, let's go.
I think it was probably, seeing as I've just shaved my head, it was probably the last of the clothes that I had that I thought would suit my new look. So all I've got now is the old surfy gear. That was kind of the sleekest clean cut stuff I had. So it's gonna be a challenge now.
You're no longer a school teacher. You're no longer a concreter.
You know, people really want it when they throw in like a $600 jacket. You know how much they want it.
Oh my God, it's all burning. I can't even look at it. I think the competition's definitely on. Everyone's willing just to throw their clothes in the fire just for a what if.
Still to come, I look around and Hannah's standing there, like giving me the biggest death stare.
And don't forget to watch Off the Runway on Tuesday night at 10:30.
It's runway day, ready to rock.
Morning bitch.
How'd you sleep?
Yeah, no, good. Excited
it's
about
good.
Today. I'm looking forward to it.
You? It's all good. Yeah, I'm excited. I'm a little bit nervous, but it's all good.
I looked in the cupboard and I always had muesli for breakfast. There was no muesli. So I was like, okay, Weet-Bix, you know, next best thing. James said it's good. He's got two Weet-Bix and I'm eating and I hear this.
What are you eating?
Me? No muesli. I'm eating Weet-Bix. I look around and Hannah's standing there, like giving me the biggest death stare.
I just want you to know that just because you say five last week doesn't mean that you'll be safe this week.
Sorry?
When you were up for nomination, like you were eating really well, and then as soon as you're not nominated anymore, you like started to slack off.
I'm having breakfast, I'm just sitting there quietly. It's just unnecessary, basically.
Hello, everyone. Being a supermodel today means being famous. Your face could be newsworthy for newspapers, magazines all over the world.
Today, models are the new rock stars.
Yes. So therefore, today's runway assignment is to sell supermodel rock star. And this is it.
Ooh, nice. And for you fellas, that's rock star. Models, you need to give it your all because at the end, we will be judging you and the three of you will be put up for the vote.
So it's your last chance to shine. So let's get you styled.
Do you want to step on there for me?
After we've just had our makeup done, we have to go and have our measurements and our weigh-ins. I'm still the same weight and my measurements are still the same, but I've probably just increased my muscle mass and lost a little bit of weight, which is what I've been aiming for.
51.5.
Wow.
That's pretty good.
I don't think I need to put on much more because I'm starting to, I've filled out enough, I reckon. I'm pretty happy with that.
56 exactly.
I lost 3 kilos. I was 59.2 and now I'm down to 56. So I'm really getting there.
Do I look funny?
You look like a penguin.
I feel like kind of like my hair's been transplanted from my head down to my feet.
We all got styled up in a rock star get-up and then, Tyson came in and pulled us all aside.
Just wanted to say I'm heading back to the States tomorrow, so this is my last few hours with you guys, and I just want you to continue on, pursue your dreams, enjoy your life, make sure you have fun doing it, all right? Work smart, not hard. That's what I always say, so. Good luck to all of you. May the best model win.
I thought my walk was really strong and really sexy and confident. Really strong look today, so that means we've got to have a strong walk.
But this is all about rock star and that hard look. I was struggling to not burst out laughing.
So Jen and Tyson, my body just goes into robot mode.
I was a little bit nervous, but I think I did well considering. It is the first time I've ever walked a straight line down and back from the catwalk. I'm so happy with myself.
Coming up.
Yeah, hey, oh, hang on a minute. Murray Clare party was not for you to let off steam.
Baby, I love you. But what's with all the tension with you and Shanina?
The winner of Make Me a Supermodel will receive a contract with Chadwick Modeling Agency, international representation with New York Model Management, and a spread in Australia's number one fashion magazine, Marie Claire.
Models, before we evaluate your work, we want to ask you a few questions.
So, Billy, you worked at the photo shoot.
I was really happy with the photo shoot.
Look, your photo shoot might have been good, and I liked your shot as well. But to be honest, at the party, I was a little disappointed. You've got to watch being talked into something, no matter who it is. He is a supermodel.
But, yeah, for sure. And to me, like, that made my night, and I had some tension during the week, and it's a weird thing.
Hey, oh, hang on a minute. You had some... my party, the Marie Claire party, was not for you to let off steam.
Sarah, what have you done this week to improve to make sure that you don't go back to that bottom three again?
I've been doing everything that I wasn't doing, so I'm just remaining focused and remembering why I'm here.
Have you dropped any weight?
I've lost 3 kilos.
Yeah. You can tell, you look great. See it.
The photo shoot's beautiful.
Yeah. I loved it. I loved what I was wearing. I felt different.
Only thing is, you're a little still too posy.
Too posy.
Yeah.
Okay.
I was at your catwalk was still very stiff.
You look like a robot in drag.
Do you think you can develop?
Yes, I do. I think my photo shoot this week went a lot better than the last photo shoot I did. The longer I'm in this competition, the better I will get.
Shanina.
Hi.
Look, I know and you know that some of the other models have been questioning your versatility this week.
Yeah, I know with my look, people are not sure about it, but I think I can prove people wrong.
Shanina, don't let them distract you from what you want to do.
Of course.
So, yeah, we're the real judges.
Yeah.
Let us judge that versatility, because I don't see any supermodel standing up there yet.
Yeah.
Hannah.
Tyson.
Baby, I love you. But what's with all the tension with you and Shanina? What's up with that?
To be honest, there actually isn't any tension between us. I've spoken to Shanina, and the fact that she said tonight that I'm bullying her really upsets me. And I hope that Sarah and Shanina can both stand forward now and understand that I'm not bullying them. I've actually helped Sarah a lot this week with her food, to the point it upsets me that they can't see that they think that I'm teaming up on them.
Okay.
I don't want to grow in this competition and them not grow with me.
It's early days. Look, things will have an ebb and flow.
They will grow. Don't worry about that, you know?
So we're going to move forward from here?
Yeah, we're going to move forward personally and professionally.
Yeah. Good girl.
Thanks, models. Please head backstage so we can assess your work. We'll see who's in the bottom three and who will face the public vote. OK, guys, let's discuss how the models went this week. There's a lot of strong shots here, but there's a few weaker shots. Tom is one of the stronger shots.
I love Tom's shot. I think it's very strong.
Yeah, I was at his shoot and he worked it well.
I have to say, Reese, one of my favourites. Mm-hmm. I think he looks like David Beckham. Terrible photograph.
This isn't the best shot of Courtney. When I saw her at the shoot, when she got in the zone, she actually did a really good job.
She wants it, but I don't know how much she actually...
She's got to toughen up a bit.
What are we going to do with Isaac?
He's a good-looking guy. He's a guy that you might see play a small part in a movie, but I don't think he's supermodel material.
Not. Personally, I think he looks great.
Very masculine to look.
Billy's listened as well, I have to say. That is such a better shot of him.
He worked it at the photo shoot.
I think Billy's got to watch it. He doesn't get carried away. He's got to watch his drinking a little bit, I think.
Lucas, it took us a lot to get even this, and he kept doing this thing with his neck.
He always says in his listening, but at the end of the day, it doesn't show through.
No.
Right.
Brooke's photograph is sensational, but nothing else cuts it.
Yeah, she's got to also pick up her attitude.
I love the shot, though, which is always frustrating.
So we've got our top three, and we know who our bottom four are, so let's get the models back out here. Next, the bottom three are revealed.
You need to step your game up.
It's up to Australia to decide who cannot be made into a supermodel. There are seven models before us. Three of you embraced your new supermodel lifestyle. Three of you are still stuck in your old ways and will face the audience vote. Shanina, once again, you did well in your photo shoot. You gave everything the photographer wanted and proved your versatility. You are safe. You may now leave the catwalk. Well done, sweetie. Tom, you only had one look on the photo shoot. But it was a great look, and you rocked it big time on the runway. You are safe. You may now leave the catwalk. Sarah. Well, what a difference a week makes. You came alive in the photo shoot. You turned up the volume on the catwalk. Well done. You've gone from the bottom three to this week's winner. Your reward is waiting for you off the runway. You may now leave the catwalk. There are now four of you standing before us. Three of you will be put up for the vote.
Isaac, once again, you were stiff as a board on your photo shoot. And your catwalk, you walked like a robot more than a rock star.
You need to relax and loosen up. Courtney, you were easily distracted and you were not concentrating at the photo shoot. You need to concentrate and learn. Same goes for your catwalk. Lucas, you need to start listening and stop giving us what you think we want. Pay attention to the photographer, man, and then you'll understand what this is all about. Brooke, on the photo shoot, the fish were more alive than you were. And on the catwalk, you look more like a dying star than a rock star. You need to step your game up.
Brooke, you're up for the vote. Lucas, you too are up for the vote. Courtney and Isaac, one of you is safe this week, but the other one will be put up for the vote. Isaac, you're up for the vote. That means, Courtney, you are safe. You may now leave the catwalk. Models, whether you stay or go is now out of our hands. It's up to Australia to decide who cannot be made into a supermodel. Good luck. You may now leave the catwalk. To save Lucas, call 1902-55-7701 or SMS his name to 191-777. To save Brooke, call 1902-55-7702 or SMS her name to 191-777. And to save Isaac, call 1902-55-7703 or SMS his name to 191-777.
I did everything that I could and I tried my best, but I had a feeling that I was going to be in the bottom three. Same. I just knew it.
I don't think I've reached my full potential, so yeah, I don't really want to go home at all, eh? I've got the other two that are up for vote. They're probably feeling exactly the same, so like I just want to support them and hopefully the right ones stay.
2 weeks in a row, been exactly the same, but I thought I had improved. I mean, I improved this week heaps more than I did last week, so I don't know. A bit dumbfounded, really.
Coming up next week, our models bear all.
Where did you sleep last night, Courtney?
I slept in my bed.
No, you didn't.
And who will face Australia's vote? Watch an exclusive interview with this week's eliminated contestant at the official Make Me a Supermodel website. Go to yahoo7.com.au/TV. And don't forget to watch Off the Runway on Tuesday night at 10:30 to find out what Shanina, Sarah and Tom get in their super reward.